Okay, children, now you are watching the third video of the chapter MySQL. We have just renamed the chapter as MySQL, but the chapter remains the same database concept. Well, we need to know what is our, you know, MySQL all about. So here we are. MySQL is actually containing a set of a coded language. We call it a structured query language. It's a standard language that is developed for accessing and modifying relational databases. It was originally developed at the IBM Research Laboratory in St. Joe's in connection with a project developing a prototype for a relational database management system called System R. Anyway, this much of information is just for your concern, that's all. You need to just understand what is SQL, and that's nothing but structured query language. And there are so many kind of relational database management system which uses MySQL. You can see MySQL on the top, then PostgreSQL, Oracle. All these uses this particular language called as SQL. What are the advantages? It's very high speed, no coding needed. That means the kind of in-depth knowledge which you had in your Python, that much of, you know, logical stability is not required to learn SQL. You have a well-defined standard and portability, that is you can change from one particular operating system to another operating system and so on. So basically in MySQL, we are going to see the, you know, most easy methodology of doing the work. This is the most popular open source database, that is, which is freely available and which is very popular on the, you know, web, and so many other platforms are there which actually supports this. And examples and features are again explained here. They are portable, same thing, secure, you know, the same knowledge about your database concept can be implemented here. So the basic knowledge, whatever we just finished, is not of much concern for you. This starts from here. We starts. What are the subdivisions of MySQL's language? Under SQL, you will be concentrating on that create, alter, drop first, then select, then insert, delete, update. These are the commands which you are going to concentrate. We call the first set of languages as DDL. So subdivisions of SQL is DDL, DQL, DML. This DQL and DML can be, you know, what we call joined together, and we can even say select, insert, delete, update. All this comes under one section. Let's start doing it without wasting time, because now it's time to concentrate on how to do it. How to create a table in MySQL, that is what you're going to do. So I hope you might have finished the installation. If you have finished, you can give this way MySQL. You can see command line client. You need to have this, and after installation you will be actually seeing this MySQL command line client. You need to just click on this only, MySQL command line client, and the password which you created or which you gave during the installation has to be given here. So my password is wrong, so I have to type once again. Sometimes I tend to forget my passwords. That is one, you know, problem nowadays. I need to keep track of my passwords. Okay, let's try once again. Yes, so this is correct. My password is correct. And I have opened. This is a prompt. So here we can actually start using your SQL language. Now first, you need to create a wardrobe. Remember what I said regarding database. So your wardrobe name is database here. So the first command under SQL is data definition language, and the first command under data definition language is create database. You give any name for it. Create database 11 IP. If I give 11 capital IP or small IP, whichever way, it is not case sensitive. I can give the same thing in small letter, nothing will go wrong there. And I put a semicolon, and you created your first database underneath this. No, just like a folder we have in the separate sections. Okay. So under this particular database, you can create table. In order to use this database, the next command should be the same. I'm using the small letter to show you. See, the IP which is given in capital is changed to small letter, but no error came and it's gone showing database changed. Here we don't have any tables now. So if you give show tables, it will be showing as empty set because I never created anything. Now, if you want, you can create a table. Now, exactly like you learned about integer, you know, decimals and all those things, you have a lot of things inside your MySQL too. See, 1 minute. See, you have decimals, you have integers, you have string. Now, decimal can be identified as DC, decimal, float. Integer can be identified as int, see. And the decimal, you can give what you call number of decimal points. All those things can be given. String is identified here as char and varchar. There is one difference between char and varchar. For the time being, we won't say that. As I told earlier, we'll talk about primary key, alternate key. We will talk about these things later. So just now you understand how you can do that. So char is there, varchar is there. Varchar means variable character. Both can be used to store string. Bracket, you can use size. Then date is there. See the format of date. This is a new data type, YYYMMDD style. In that you can store. And now we are going to see the first command inside this to create a table. So see, create. The table is to be given. These are already made commands. Now I'm going to give a name to that. Okay, now for example, this is my table name. You can start with a with or without a space bracket. Okay, this bracket starts where you can give the field names, it is a column names. Now for example, the roll number being integer, I can give int. Then student name being character, I can give char or varchar. How many numbers or how many size you want, that you have to decide now itself. 10, if it is required, give 10, 20, then 20. Then you have your, you know, usual, you know, your grade or marks or whatever it is. For the time being, grade, float. Suppose the maximum number of number which can come is 4, out of which 2 should be decimal, isn't it? Or the maximum can be come number of numbers can be 5, out of which 2 decimal points. So 100 can come, 100.00 can come. Understood? So the number of values maximum can go for 5, out of which 2 should be decimal, which is half the float. I can give float or des or decimal, anything. We will try with one of this and then we will change. I can give date of birth also. So DOB I am giving later, and the format is date. So int, char, DC, date are the integer specification. What, not integer specification, data type specification. What is it going to, what type of values is it going to hold? Roll number, S name, marks and DOB. DOB is a short form of date, are the field names or attributes name or the column names. And you close it and put a semicolon. If no errors are there, it will say query OK. So your structured query language first command is almost set. Zero rows affected means no rows are right now created, but the table is there. Now if I write DEC, which is a short form of describe, and if I give, it will come like this way. It will show what you have done. Roll number, int, S name, marks. Des is been now identified as decimal. DOB is date. And there are other things which you need not worry about. Now it is important that you put values into this. So create table is what kind of a command? It is a DDL command, data definition. Okay, no? DDL, data definition language, where with the help of which I created the syntax is create table, then give a table name, open the bracket, give the field name, then the size, comma, and second field name, then the size. If the size you need to give a, you know, not size, the data type, I am repeatedly saying it wrong. Roll number, it is your, you know, data, that variable name, then the data type, comma, then again another, you know, variable name, then another data type. If you need to give a size, you have to give a size in the brackets. Integer, you not given a size, but you can see a size came automatically 11 because it's a default size taken. So that's it. You can give like this, and as long as you want, you can put a comment, do keep on adding new values, and at last you put a semicolon, and before that you close the bracket. So semicolon is something which you haven't seen in Python. In Python you never had anything like this, but here semicolon indicates the end of the statement, and that completes your first command. Now you have what we call this the insert. You are putting the values into this. Insert into, what are you inserting? Values. So insert into which one? Table. So the command comes under the second section called as DML. Data manipulation language. Insert into student values. What are you going to put the values? The first roll number should have some values. You put roll number as 1. S name, you give it as any name you want. Capital or small letter, but it should be in quotes because it's a character value. Okay, and the marks can be 45 if you want, then automatically 0.00 will come there. Your date should be in quotes, even though it's not a string, your date style should be in quotes, and you need to give that in your style. See, YYYMMDD, quotes closed. Now if I write the old command, you know what I did? I put and I am pressing my up arrow, that up arrow, then the old commands will come. You have a table called a student, and inside that table you have a particular row, a tuple is created. See, query, okay, one row effect. In order to see the tuple, if you write select, that's the next command. So DDL, create table we learned, DML, now insert into we learned, and DML next command, or DQL, data query language. If I write select star, star stands for all. Select star from which table? Student, semicolon. See, now this creates a table or relation which is having the field name as roll numbers, as name, marks, and DOB as the names or the field. And 1 Jasmine 45.00, that date of birth is given as a tuple. So you have one tuple. So degree, number of columns you have as 4, and cardinality you have only one row, it is one row. Cardinality equal to 1 and degree equal to 4. So you have a table now where roll number, S name, marks are called your field names. The only one tuple is there consisting of Jasmine 1 Jasmine 45 2001 04. So you can keep on adding this. Once you insert more values, and again you try. So your task after watching this video is only this much. Try to insert values. Again, I put an up arrow like this. Change the values. And give a new name. Video lease, so give 05. Change this into something which is relevant, 23. See, now if you put an up arrow and see, now two rows, understood? Now tuples are increasing. So you have to like this, input at least 10 values and keep it ready for the next video. So that's how we are going to end this. So thank you for watching this. I'm sure that you will be completing this by your next working day, that is Monday. Monday by evening this should be ready. Morning we will be probably having the exam only. So you go through this and make sure that by Monday this file should be ready. If you have problem with the installation, you should be telling me in the morning sessions, Google Meet. Okay, so thank you very much. We will continue this in the Google Meet.